sad to say, ignore what's going on here. There will be the ability, particularly in rich countries, to open up if things are done well over the next few months. But for the world at large, normalcy only returns when we've largely vaccinated the entire global population. And
we are beginning a program today, and it's a pilot program, which will certainly grow into something larger and larger, and that is a community contact tracing program. We've done contact tracing all along. That contact is a person who's been exposed to someone that we document to have the COVID infection. When we find someone who has a COVID infection, those people are immediately isolated. But we also work with them to figure out who their contacts were. Luckily, because you have been doing such a great job of cooperating and staying indoors, staying isolated, it used to be there were 10 contacts at least for every patient that we would find. Now it looks like there are probably only 2 or 3 or 4 contacts, not surprisingly, because most people have been staying away from others. And that's good news. But the purpose of this program is to bring on people. We're going to start with 10 people. We may bring on up to 50 or even more as the program grows and as we see the needs for it. As we do more testing, we will find more and more people who have COVID-19. And again, we'll isolate every one of them, and we will find every one of their contacts. And we will make sure that they stay quarantined, and we'll check in with them every day. There are going to be thousands of people hired who will be these contact investigators throughout the state. And this is occurring in many, many other states as well, perhaps all of the states in our country. We will be giving intensive training to these people, training not only for identifying and finding contacts, but also in terms of how to be sensitive about doing it. We also realize that as we find more contacts, some of the people we find are going to have trouble being isolated. For instance, if they live in a home where there's only one bathroom and there are 3 or 4 other people living there, and those people don't have COVID infection, we're not going to be able to keep the person in that home. Every person who we're isolating, for instance, needs to have their own bathroom. And so we'll be moving people like this into other kinds of housing that we have available.
Disgusting.
Check it, you little sucker.